Good morning, my dear students. Welcome to online classes. This is C.H. John Paul, lecturer in English of Sri Venkateswara College of Arts and Science, Amalapuram, affiliated to Adikavan Anna University, Rajamahendravaram, who have been discussing about the second year, fourth semester CSS paper, communication on soft skills paper. And in this paper contains 5 units. These 5 units, first and second, third, 3 units are completed, and we are discussing fourth unit. The fourth unit name is letter writing. In this unit, 2 topics are there. First one is letter writing, second one is e-correspondence. First topic is also completed, letter writing. We have seen formal letters, informal letters, other types of letters, formats, essential things, all these things are learned. And now the second topic is e-correspondence. This topic we are discussing in this video. So e-correspondence, E means electronic mail. E means electronic mail letter. That is the meaning of E. So e-correspondence refers to the corresponding someone using email with it evident of internet and technology. Writing physical letters has become rare. Most of the correspondence is made on email. As you are aware, email is fast and can reach any corner of the world any time of the day. It is not surprising to say that email has converted the world into a global village. World into a global village. This is the general information about the e-correspondence. So, the definition of email, it means transformation of information from one system or person to another system or person. Technically speaking, email is a method of communication. Whereby an individual or a company uses a computer or some other electronic device like a cell phone or any computer or anything to compose and send a message to another individual or a group of individuals. So communicating with the help of electronic equipment means things, computers or internet, etc., is correspondence. E for electronic. E correspondence also has all the basic features of conventional mode of communication. It means using paper and pen or print with some minor change caused by computer etiquette. Etiquettes means rules, a polite rules like that. E-correspondence is the fastest mode of communication. It reaches any corner of the world in seconds, and it functions round the clock all the days. So e-correspondence has replaced normal correspondence to a great extent, growing use of e-correspondence, it means email, has resulted in increasing importance to email etiquette. So now we are trying to learn email etiquettes. Some etiquettes are there, rules basis on the email letter. Email etiquettes, how to write a email, that before you have learned email etiquettes. Email etiquettes. Though basic correspondence has not changed much, e-correspondence has involved certain etiquette. We shall look at them below. Be careful in typing the email ID of the person who you are writing. The next one, a single character like alphabet or number or a punctuation mark in the email address will make the mail bounce or post the mail to somebody else's mailbox. Therefore, there is a need to double check the spelling of the mail ID before you click on the send button. A better way to avoid a mistake in the email ID is to save all the email IDs and retrieve them when needed. Like typing the email ID accurately is very important. Even a small change in spaces, numbers, punctuation marks, etc. can reject the transmission of the mail or sending it to someone else. Hence, be very careful when typing the ID and double check it before sending it. So, maintain official and private mail IDs separately. Open your, it means keep the private and official mails separate. When should not use the same ID for both of them? Usually all official communication is saved for future use. Official mails is office property. Therefore, others may access your official mailbox when you are on leave. So open your mailboxes regularly, respond immediately, remove junk like unimportant, irrelevant, etc. frequently. We make an email a smart one, that is good email properties. So don't leave email boxes unopened. You should access your mail as frequently as possible so that you can be in touch with others. delete the junk immediately, otherwise you may overlook an important mail when it is mixed with junk mail. Try to reply the mails immediately. Try to reply the mails immediately. It means a clear subject line showing. Line showing what the mail is about. It means a smart email is one which has a clear subject line. The subject line should reflect what the mail deals with. Just hi or hello will not help the reader decide how important the mail is. So second one, brief to the point, easy to read quickly. It means a smart email is one which is brief, because reading anything from the monitor is harder and slower than reading a hard copy of the same text. Since it is easy to send and receive emails, the mailboxes of many executives and professionals are overloaded with mails. Therefore, there is not much time to spend on lengthy emails. The next one, with no irrelevant or unnecessary details. A smart email is one which does not contain any unnecessary information or is not attached with unnecessary files. Don't attach a graphic file unless it is necessary. They take long to download. So the last one, your email must be in simple, plain, error-free language. So a smart email is one which is written in simple and error-free language. Error-free language. So try to avoid spelling mistakes, grammatical errors, and errors in punctuation. Emails are neither very formal nor informal. Therefore, the language should also be neither too formal or informal. Try to avoid personal abbreviations and emotions. These are etiquette of email writing. Email etiquettes are, we have seen some important and major things. So which one of the email is better? Which one of the email is better? The second mail is better. What is it? The second mail is better. And next question. Which one looks informal and why? first one looks informal. It starts with hi, an informal way of greeting. Questions, requests, etc. are not informal style. They are not even polite. They look as if they were addressed to a younger person or friend, etc. The next question, the subject line of which email is clear and specific. The subject line of the second email is clear and specific. And finally, the fourth question is, the first email contains unnecessary information. Underline the unnecessary information in the first email. I think we have not had students from India. I want to know something since my childhood. I have been interested in learning foreign languages. I am a rank holder, so I think I can easily do your courses. These are general questions to give the answers. And one more important thing is, while before writing email letter, tips for writing emails. General tips are there. Now we are discussing tips for writing emails. The first point is, be sure an email is necessary. This is the first tip of the writing a good email letters. It means, like most of the email writing tips in this section, this may seem obvious, but sometimes we forget obvious things. So, ask yourself, is there a better or faster way to take care of this situation? Many people get dozens or even hundreds of emails a day. So be sure that email is the fastest, clearest, and most efficient way to communicate in your situation. Second one is, the second tip of email writing is, use separate business and personal email address. This may not apply to everyone, but if you cannot do it, it can help you in many ways. Many jobs automatically give you an email address that you have to use. If that's the case, then the problem is solved. Use the business email addresses for work and your personal email address for personal emails. This is the second tip of good writing of email. Use separate business and personal email addresses. The third tip is be clear, brief and polite. What is it? The third one is be clear, brief and polite. If your email is confusing, angry or really long, the recipient may not respond right away. Eventually, they may forget to answer or even just delete it. So be sure to get to the point quickly, but not in a rude way. Treat an email similarly to an essay, only much shorter, and you will probably have to introduce the topic, explain the different points, and then conclude the topic. This is the third tip of be clear, brief, and polite. The fourth one is don't write emails when you are angry. This is very important tip of good writing email letter. Don't write emails when you are angry. It means it can be very tempting to write a mean email when you are frustrated or angry at something, but it's not worth it. If you are angry, wait until you have calmed down before writing your email. It's better to wait a day than to lose a job or destroy a friendship because you said something stupid when you are angry. The fifth tip is use short sentences like has three. This is a problem that I have myself. I like to write a long, complicated sentences, but often those are very confusing for the reader. That's especially true if the reader is not a native English speaker. So use short sentences like not that. And the sixth one is avoid forwarding mails and replying to all. Avoiding forwarding mails and replying to all. The forward option on email is a blessing. It means a good thing. Uncure, it means a bad thing. Curse, not cure, curse. A bad thing. It can be good to quickly pass on important information to a new person. However, it can also be annoying for the recipient if it is not used correctly. It means the same thing, it is true about the reply all option. If you need to forward an email, check carefully what information you are forwarding. This is very important. Check carefully what information you are forwarding. And the seventh tip is, use a spell checker. Most emails programs have this option. So make sure you use it before sending the emails to get the most accurate version. To get accurate version of Grammarly or Grammatically, you will need to make sure you have Grammarly pronomen, which highlights and offers corrections. For more advanced English issues, this is the use spell checker. The next one is, eighth tip is, watch out for signature. Many people put cool or funny signatures at the bottom of emails. They often include contact information like email addresses or phone numbers that can be useful, but if your emails get forwarded /5, that information may get to people you don't know, or even people you would not want to have that information. So ninth tip is, have a native speaker proofread your email if possible. It means if you know any native speakers or have friends who speak English very well, you may want to ask them to review your email before you send it. That especially true if it is about something important. If you are taking an English class, you might even be able to ask your teacher to review the email. Just be sure to ask necessary nicely and say please, and say please. The 10th tip is read your email personally before sending it. Before sending it. It might not always be possible to find a native speaker to check your email. In those cases, it's still useful to read your email yourself. It can help your English too. This is the tips, and some more tips are there. And 11th one is use the subject line. It's surprising how many people don't do this. What is it? Use the subject line. It's surprising. It's surprising how many people don't do this. So that's why you have a clear subject line. The subject line should reflect what the mail deals with. Just hi, hello, will not help the reader. Will not help the reader. Decide how important the mail is. That is the very important. The next one is start with an appropriate greeting. Use the perfect greeting. Greetings. Hi, sir, madam, or etc. This is very, very important. And the next one is pay attention to punctuations. So brief, because reading anything from the monitor is 100 and slower than reading a hard copy of the same text. Since it is easy to send and receive emails, the mailboxes of many executive and professionals are overloaded with mails. Therefore, there is not much time to spend on lengthy emails. The next one is consider where to put small talk. It means does not contain any unnecessary information or is not attached with necessary files. Don't attach a graphic file unless it is necessary. They take long to download. So start with an appropriate greeting. Pay attention to punctuation. Consider where to put small talk. The next one is start with the end in mind. This is also very important. So if it is written in a simple and error-free language, try to avoid spelling mistakes, grammatical errors, in punctuation, email are either very formal or informal. Therefore, the language should also be neither too formal nor informal. To avoid personal abbreviations and emotions. The next one is put spaces between paragraphs. If it is possible, can divide it into three paragraphs of the body of the letter. Introduction, content, and conclusion. These three are very important. In the body of the paragraphs, can divide it into paragraphs like. And the last one is use an appropriate closing. This is a subscriptions like yours faithfully, yours sincerely, yours truly, yours obediently, yours faithfully, like this. In formal, yours affectionately, yours lovingly, see, like this. Use in or closing appropriate greeting, appropriate end of the greeting. And general rules for formal emails. Formal emails. Formal emails are there, informal emails are there. Two types of emails is there. Formal emails too means write to officials and business and editors, offices, banks, like this. We must maintain the some rules in formal emails or formal letters because of the higher authorities, higher officials are there, like teachers, collectors, CM, and all type of designation persons. So general rules for formal emails, this is formal. And informal means write to our friends, parents, relatives, and colleagues, etc. Colleagues also formal and etc. So informal letters are as you wish, allowed in colloquial language. But the general rules for formal emails, first one is politeness. We should maintain politeness. And the second one is formality. We should maintain one format and formats. And second one, clarity. Clear and simple, free verse language. And the next one, requests. If it is used, requests. The next one is greetings. Use the greetings. Hi. Not use that in formal. Sir or madam. If you know that the officials, dear sir. Closings, that is subscriptions, you should maintain. You sincerely, you truly, so you obediently, you faithfully, like that. And give the samples and examples. These are seven rules for when you are writing formal emails. So you play this class, next class how to create email ID and email ID, after that compose and advantage, disadvantage, and example you have seen the next class. Thank you so much.